Hey everybody, this is John Marucci coming to you live from Ludington State Park, consistently rated the number one state park in the state of Michigan. Now, Ludington State Park is rated number one for many reasons, including the incredible amount of hiking that we have here in Ludington, as well as Lake Hamlin, Lake Michigan, great sand dunes, the ability to bike and fish and do water sports. So there's so many great things here at Ludington State Park to do. You know, one of the other things I really like about the state park is all the wildlife. When we were camping here, we saw a bunch of stuff, including deer. And the deer really aren't that skittish. We were hiking a little bit and deer were literally 20 to 30 feet off the trail and didn't run away too quickly. It's really cool to be able to see deer in a natural surrounding like this. Besides the plethora of chipmunks that are around, which are kind of fun to watch. Actually, we were sitting down one day and had one come in the screened-in tent for just a moment before it realized where it was and headed out. And you know, it's cool. We saw some geese and goslings out by the lake the other day. Just a nice mix of wildlife while we're here as well. You'll see various kinds of birds as well. And it's just a fun place to be. The wildlife just is all around. Just keep your eyes open while you're hiking and while you're at your campsite. You know, it's 5,300 acres. There's 352 campsites. So it's really a great place to come. So a wonderful place, Ludington State Park, normally rated first in Michigan. Now let's talk about the main things we talk about when we do a campsite review. The first thing being hospitality and check-in. So this is very good. It's generally the same as going to other state parks where you drive up, you go to the ranger station, you check in, you tell them what your site number is. They usually ask you for your plate and if you have a recreational passport, and then they give you the slip of paper for the front of your vehicle and you go to find your site. Pretty simple. You do have to get out of your car. It's just a little bit of walking, but not much. At Ludington, it's about 2.5 miles away, just under 2.5 miles away from the actual campsites where you check in. So just be aware of that. But generally, very good situation, hospitality and check-in, not too difficult at all. You know, the second thing we look at is infrastructure and amenities. And infrastructure here is really very good. All the roads around the park and all the campsites are paved. You're not talking about dirt ruts. You're not talking about gravel. They're all paved. It's very established. The amenities here are good. Some of them aren't new, but they're kept clean and well-maintained. So the bathrooms, you know, all have good hot showers, although some of them probably could be due for a remodel in some of the campsites. But generally, pretty good stuff for infrastructure and amenity. You know, there's no laundry here to be aware of. So if you're thinking you're going to come here after a long trip and do laundry, you're going to be out of luck. And the other thing to be aware of, the state park doesn't have a gate. Unlike some of them in other states where you actually have a gate that you passcode in, after hours it's not gated. They are manned to about 10 o'clock, usually in the summer hours, but they're not gated. Okay, so the third thing we look at is site quality. And this is really mixed. In some places it's pretty good, other places really not so good. So there's three big campsite rings at Ludington: the Pines campsite, which is closest to Lake Michigan, the Cedar campsite in the middle, and then the Beechwood campsite, which is closest to Hamlin Lake. And, you know, it varies very much between the campsites and even within the campsite rings, the quality of the sites. You can't give it high ratings because some of the sites are just not level at all. They're really made for tent camping. Some of them are made for RV camping. So just be aware, you want to do your research when you try to book here to look at the site quality and look at the dimensions and whether it's level or not. Some of them just aren't level. There is some privacy, but not too much. Most of these sites are right next to each other. There's no berms or anything between the sites like most Michigan state parks. So be aware of that. If you're thinking you're going to come and be far away from your neighbors, you're probably not going to have that luxury. And the other thing is there are no full hookups. Everything here is electric. Now, they do have 50 amp and 30 amp, but it's just electric. No city water, no full hookups, no sewer. So be aware of that. Like most state parks, it's just electric. But the site quality in general varies. I'd have to give it a good rating because some of them are good and some of them not so good. Okay, then the fourth thing we look at is exercise and exercise ability. Now, Ludington is outstanding in this regard because you have so many opportunities to exercise. You can run so many trails. There's biking. There's a lot of paved bike trails. And there's a ton of hiking. Again, there's 21.5 miles of hiking trail, and some of them are quite exquisite. Some of the hikes, in fact, go really high up in altitude in terms of being able to look over Lake Michigan, look over Hamlin Lake. There's great sand dunes, natural sand dunes, even at those high places in the hike where you can, you know, divert and look at the sand dunes and such. So it's a lot of fun. and the trails are outstanding. This is probably some of the best hiking in lower Michigan. So a lot of fun with hiking. Biking, I just talked about. Make sure you bring your bikes if you can, because there's a lot of fun bike trails out you can do too. Most of them paved too around the campsite. So it's quite large. Again, 5,300 acre total as far as Ludington State Park. And even swimming. There's opportunities to swim in Hamlin Lake, etc. The other thing I didn't talk about is all the opportunities with watercraft and boating. You know, there's a place on Lake Hamlin where you can rent all kinds of watercraft, including things like paddle boats and canoes and kayaks. So if you didn't bring your own, you can go and rent them for the day at reasonable prices and get out on the water if that's what you want to do. Okay, so exerciseability is just outstanding, really. Really good value for exercise. Okay, and the fifth thing we look at is workability. So workability is pretty good. And at times it's good here on the Beechwood. We're in the Beechwood campground, and you do have AT&T internet here as far as cell bandwidth. We got about 16 megabits down and 2 up using the iPhone. If we use the WeBoost with the iPhone, it went a little bit better to about 20 down and 5 up. The other campsites though, if you go to Cedar or go over close to the lake at Pines, you're not going to get any bandwidth at all, at least not with AT&T cellular. They just don't show up at all. You get no service. So be aware of that. If you're thinking you're going to come here and get internet on all the campsites, make sure you camp at Beechwood, because you're not going to get, at least with AT&T, you're not going to get bandwidth on the other campsites. So be aware of that. But generally, we're here at Beechwood this week. We did work all week, and it went really well. At times, the bandwidth knocked us off a little bit of the VPN, then we got right back on. It wasn't a big deal at all. So workability, I have to say, is good, but not great. But if you're going to work here, you got to get at Beechwood. All right, so those are the five things: hospitality and check-in, infrastructure, site quality, exerciseability, and workability. So what would I give it for an overall grade? I'd say it's very good, mainly because the quality of the amenities and the ability to do various things, especially hiking and biking, and hit the natural sand dunes and head over to Lake Michigan, which is really nice as well. In fact, over at the lake, they have a great little store and place that you can change and get out to the beach. So overall, very good rating. There's a reason why Ludington's rated number one in Michigan, and it's because all that you can do here. So much variety and exercise and getting outdoors. Anyway, this is a campsite review for Ludington. Hopefully it's helpful. Again, if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. This is John Marucci, and feel free to subscribe. We'd love to have you on the channel and love making these videos for you. And if you hit the bell icon, you'll get notified by email each time we put a new video up. So again, thank you for watching. This is John Marucci. Have a great day.